Betty's Kitchen. Today we're going on a field trip. It's going to be Rick and me and Chris and Chelsea and Carter. And the purpose of our trip is to go to a place in Georgetown, Kentucky called Evans Farm. And we hope to pick out a pumpkin to use for a jack-o'-lantern. So that's our main reason for going. But that farm has a lot of things to do. I've not personally been there. Now, Chelsea and Chris and Carter went last year and enjoyed it, but they have a lot of things like apples that you can pick from the tree. During the summer, they will have green beans and squash and corn and everything. I don't know how far through the summer they are, so I don't know what will be available. They do have some things to eat. We'll probably eat there. I know they are famous for their fried apple pies, and they sell over 20,000 per year. So I plan to get one of those. So I can't tell you much more about it until we get there, but I'll see you at Evans Farms. We just arrived at Evans Orchard, and Chris and Chelsea and Carter and Remy, the dog, have started up in that direction, and notice that there are little ponies here that the kids can ride. Of course, you pay for anything that you do. And next to it, apple cider slider. I'm sure that's something that Carter will want to do. So we'll see about getting into some of the play areas. But this is an orchard where you get to pick your own fruit off the trees. You can buy apple cider. You can buy jams and jellies. I've not been here, so wait until we get to some of the places and I'll show you what we see. I want you to see behind me, there is a camel ride going on. So Kentucky is not well known for camels, but evidently here we have some unusual animals. Rick and I just paid $2 each to get on the wagon ride, and we're going to ride through the orchard. He's starting up the tractor, and we're on a trailer. So basically, this orchard has apple trees. A different kind of tree. These are peach trees. They're not labeled, so I can't tell you what varieties of peaches there are. They have already been picked for the year because the season ended already for peaches. The type of tree has changed. It's a pear tree, and you can actually see pears on the ground. Actually, they're edible. They have a tendency to fall off the tree, but generally I'm sure they get picked before that point. There are several pumpkin patches, and here's one of them, and they've been laid out there. And I'm sure we'll be looking for a pumpkin later in the day. Entrance, and Carter's already in there, so we'll see if we can find him, and either he gets out safely or we do, or hopefully both. Hey Carter, where are you? Well, we may be spending the rest of our day hunting for Carter. We're lost in the maze.
He may be out of it.
Yeah, could be.
We'll keep going.
Carter
is found, but we're still in the maze.
How do we get out?
Which way?
How do we get out? We went that way.
All right, let's go that way.
Hey, no. It's still not getting.
Let's go. Carter found the way out.
It's a gate, dude.
Good job!
Yay!
Good job!
We decided to have lunch right here at Evans Orchard. Got music playing over there. And I want to show you what I got.
I got just a plain hot dog, which I put mustard on, and some potato chips, and the drink I have, you've seen recently in Betty's Kitchen, a late one, which is kind of local to this area. So I'll just take the cap off. And I've worked up a sweat, so let's see what Rick has. Rick has, what's that?
It's a jumbo all beef hot dog.
And he's put some tomatoes on it.
Try to make it Chicago style as close as I can.
And he's got some harvest cheddar sun chips. And probably everybody has something similar.
Well, not necessarily. I have some barbecue pulled pork.
Oh, that looks great.
They say it's made with their apples somehow.
Yeah, very sweet.
And then I got some toppings for it too. I'll just show right there. They had a little bar up there. And Chris's.
Here's a orchard burger. I don't know if it has anything to do with the orchard or not, other than the name. But
looks good.
Close enough.
And this is Remy's hot dog. That you'll get to make. And what'd you get?
I got some cheesy chips and the juice.
And you want the bun off this hot dog?
Yeah. Okay. And I got bread.
Okay, bread. Great. He loves bread. I just got back with my fried apple pie, so let's see what it's like.
You need a napkin?
Here it is. It's pretty big. It's just a half moon shape. Break it open in the center. That's what it looks like. Here's a little orchard trivia. How many apples does it take to make a gallon of cider? About 36. Energy is needed from how many leaves to produce one apple? 5, 15, 25, or 50? 50. Why does an apple float? Because 25% of their volume is air. How many pounds of apples does it take to make a 9-inch pie? 2 pounds. Here's the Evans Orchard store, and you can buy a little bit of everything here. You can get some memorabilia, some stuffed animals, you can get cards. Keychains. You can get tomatoes if you want them. Here are some sweet potatoes. And we have caramel corn over there. And here you're going to see something that is familiar from my kitchen. This is salsa. It's a spicy kind, and they also have the sweet kind. And remember the A81 barbecue sauce? That's it. And they have other things like corn relish, chow, apple relish, apple butter, pumpkin butter, and lots of other canned goods. So if you like things that are fresh and local, then this is a place to get it. Evans Orchards has its own line of pickle and preserved varieties of fruits and vegetables. There is anything you might want, from dill pickles to sweet potato butter to pear butter to apple butter, lots of stuff. And it really looks good and appetizing. Looks like some cookbooks here that are Kentucky style as well. If you have a taste for apple cider, there's plenty right there. And then candy apples. This is a pie pumpkin. There are a whole bunch right here. Last year when we went to a different farm, it was Baldwin Farms in Madison County, and I bought one of these, and then when I got home I thought what you all would want would be something from the can. So I made my pumpkin pie using canned pumpkin, and I think probably whatever I make this year, I don't know what it's going to be, it'll be from the can. So I'm not going to buy this time, but it looks good. We've been looking at this little field of pumpkins. It's just one of the many fields of pumpkins, and it's very small compared to some of the others. But we're going to pick out a pumpkin, and I think
you want me to go find one?
Chelsea has some good eyes for pumpkins, so
well,
she's going to get one.
They almost look all alike, but I'll see what I can do. We want to get one that's fairly round. I think maybe Carter would enjoy carving it, maybe with my dad. How about this one? This one looks pretty good.
Looks good.
Didn't have any dent or anything? Not a major dent.
I think that looks like a nice one.
Yeah, that has a good cap.
Good stem. Let's get this. Carter's looking over the gourds. He's going to pick some out. There he goes. He's got a couple there.
Or you want the orange ones? Like the white ones? Or orange?
That's what you want? Wow, that's a lot of stems.
There's something up here?
Alright, I'll hold that for you. Okay, one of these? These you can make little itty bitty jack-o'-lanterns with.
Oh, that's cute. Do you like that one?
That one? Do you like the bigger ones like that? That's probably the biggest one here.
Yeah, that's really orangey too.
You like that one?
All right. I think we're all set.
What has
on it? These are mine.
Those are great.
We have finished our day of fun at Evans Orchard and we're going to head back to Richmond. I'll be showing you some Kentucky scenery on the way home. Hope you enjoy it.